everybody. Today I am going to be unboxing the newest Holo Taco Collection box. This is the Dark Rainbow box. I am a huge fan of holographic color shifting things in general, and I love Holo Taco because they cater so much to the color shifting world. And this collection in particular is extra focused on the rainbows that I love so much. This is the third addition to a bit of a running series. I believe this is the final chapter, if you will, of the linear rainbow saga. The first rainbow linear holographic collection was released, I believe, the first year of Holo Taco. And then the next year, the pastel rainbows were released. And this year, we are getting the dark rainbows. I have seen the previews, and I've seen the polishes inside of their cartridges, but I have waited until this video to actually take the polishes out of the boxes and get a good look. So I'm very excited to see all the glittery goodness inside. But first, I will be examining this box. I always love the collection boxes from Holo Taco. I really feel like they add to the overall experience. So as you can see, the box here is holographic. There is a printed rainbow here, but there is also the holographic rainbow color shift as well. And of course you have the brand name Holo Taco linear holographic nail polish. On the side here, there is also dark rainbow colors, which is very appropriate. Those are the details I love about these boxes. The back has the print from the front. It runs all the way around to the back. You can see all these lighter shapes on here from the branding. Very subtle. They're raised a bit. You can hear them as I run my fingers over. And again, you have that same holographic. Holo Taco Dark Rainbow Collection. Lost in the Woods. Sunken Secrets. violet nightmares, dead petals, crimson void, burnt bridges, and amber apathy. This is a fall-themed box, perhaps even a bit October flair with the sunken secrets, lost in the woods, nightmares, burnt bridges, apathy. It's got a bit of a dark feel to it, doth the Dark Rainbow Collection. Holotaco.com @Holotaco. Vegan, cruelty-free, and made in the USA. Flammable, keep away from heat, keep away from children, do not eat. Very important. Holo Taco and the Holo Taco logo are trademarks of Simply Nailogical Inc., manufactured for Holo Taco in Passaic, New Jersey, 07055, made in the USA. This white text and logo are raised. You can feel them again as I put my fingers across it. I can feel the raised printed on top of the smoother surface. There you can see a bit of a close up there of all of the colors and the text. I really love the simplicity of the design of this box. It still has all of the multicolored rainbows that I enjoy, but it looks so elegant on this black backdrop. Okay, so let's get inside. I know that's the most important part. Again, it is magnetized. More rainbows coming across. And inside, we have the rainbow continues along the plate here. And you see, can you see a rainbow in the dark? You have more of these big, spiky rainbows of color-shifting goodness going back and forth here. I love this. This is such a unique holo effect where it's, instead of glittering, it's just like spiking up and down. It's so perfect for this edgier, darker rainbow collection. I can't stop looking at that. It's so cool. Okay. And here we have the polishes. And I will go from here over to here. And as we go, I am going to swatch the colors on these swatch sticks, and that way it can help me choose which one I want to paint my nails with, because I am at a loss. All of them are so beautiful, so I will definitely need to swatch them to decide. So when I open one, I'm going to start a swatch, do the first coat. And then, after we have looked at all of them, I will do a second coat. So, I am going to take all of these out of the box to start with. In the last box, it was flocked, like velvet, but this one has the printing on top here. I think that looks really nice. Okay, let's put this up here. Let's get it to, yeah, you can still see it while I go over these. So first, we have Lost in the Woods. I think this is a big contender for which one I want to paint my nails with first. My favorite color is green, and this is such a beautiful, deep forest green. And the holo particles are so bright and noticeable. This is definitely green, but the rainbow is practically a color all by itself. Lost in the Woods. But this is definitely an early favorite for me. Let's get one of these. Nail mat just off camera. So I will do a quick swatch. So pretty. Then I will move it over to dry as I move on. Next one, I think I can do a bit thicker. If you're quick, you can do another coat on the first layer. So there that is, with just one quick coat. And have this back here, and it will come back momentarily, because next we have Sunken Secrets. Now, I did say that the green is my favorite at first, but I have seen a few pictures of people using this blue, and I just love it too. Oh my gosh, it is so deep. This name, Sunken Secrets, that is a perfect name for this polish. This is linear holographic, but the individual holographic glitters are so big and bright. It is almost like two colors in one, rainbow holographic and blue. There's the blue. And there's the rainbow. Sunken Secrets. I that might be my favorite name, just because I think it's so appropriate. All the names in this collection are great, but Sunken Secrets is so perfectly descriptive. Let's get a swap here. Trying not to spill. It's about as dark a blue as you can get before it starts getting confused for black. Which is my favorite kind of blue. Wow, this is so rich. Even on just the first swipe, that is so dark. Do this one now. It's gonna be very hard to choose. I guess I shouldn't have put that away. It'll be coming back in a moment. Next is the Violet Nightmares. Oh, that is nice too. A lot, or in the past, a lot of the purples from Holo Taco skewed a bit blue, but lately the purples have just been spot on. I love them. This is a nice like eggplant, deep purple, Violet Nightmare. Even more beautiful out of the bottle. It is so very purple. There's no mistaking this for blue or black. This is definitely a purple linear. Holographic. I love doing these swatches because I don't have to worry about how messy I make. Oh my gosh. That may be a one coater. And it is definitely darker than the camera is depicting. Next, we have Dead Petals. This is another favorite name. I think Dead Petals, while macabre, is a very appropriate name for this polish. And also an appropriate name for a collection like this. It is another bit of a purple, but it's a bit more fuchsia, magenta, on the pink end of purple, a red violet. I love that. That is very nice. The rainbow is so strong. In the bottle, it's so strong that sometimes I can't really get a good eye on the color until I get it out of the glass. There's almost right there. It's about the right color, and perhaps there-ish. Yes. Very creative names for this collection. And to take a quick break, the neighbor's air conditioning came on. I'm hoping that maybe I can eventually figure out how to use a different room in the house for filming, so that maybe I won't be able to pick up her fan, but no guarantees there, just working on it. Oh, see, there we go. Now you can really see what I meant by that pinkish color, as opposed to it being another purple. I'm partial to the violet one, but I do really like this. Okay. That was Dead Petals. And next, we have another one that I really like from pictures I've seen, and that is Crimson Void. I am not normally a big fan of red for my nails, but I love maroon, and this is much closer to a maroon than a bright red or even a burgundy. Crimson Void. This is another case where in the glass it's a bit hard to see beyond the holographic bits, but right about there you can see the red. And once I swatch it, you will definitely see it. think I'm also maybe picking up another neighbor's fan. That's a bit farther away. So I've been keeping the bits in with their AC fan, but cutting out the one that's right out of this window. I hope that's okay. Oh, you can see the red from this distance, that beautiful deep maroon. This is such a vampire color. I see like very like blood and wine and garnets. Makes me think of Interview with a Vampire. Super nice. I love this. And this is a red that you could do for both fall and winter. It has a bit of that deep rose wine color that I could see at Christmas as well as Halloween and Thanksgiving. Ooh, it may be between this one, Into the Woods, and Sunken Ship. Crimson Void, Into the Woods, and Sunken Ship. So far, it's gonna be hard to choose between those. We still have two more after this. This is a big collection. Next, we have Burnt Bridges. Again, I keep mentioning I love the names in this collection. Christine of Holo Taco, she always does a great job naming the polishes. But in particular, the names of this collection really capture the essence of what this collection is about. Burnt Bridges. This would be the orange of the rainbow, but she went more brown, as there is a general lack of brown variety in the Holo nail world. Not a lot of holographic brown polish. You can see the brown better from down here, but it is there. Okay, most of these are looking much more apparent. The colors are more apparent when you swatch them. The glass really highlights the holographic qualities. Oh wow, that is such a rich milk chocolate brown. This is a perfect fall shade. So many companies go with orange when it comes to cosmetics. And I think that's It's because browns often fall into the purview of beige and classic and just having a clean look and being maybe a bit boring, as opposed to holographic, which is exciting and different. So maybe they don't think to put browns out as a specialty color for fall. But I really appreciate Holo Taco providing some cool brown polishes. And by cool, I don't mean cool toned. I just mean a brown polish that is not boring. This one will definitely need two coats, but I really like that. That also looks quite nice. And personally, not a huge fan of orange, so I'm quite happy to get brown, because I will use a brown polish, but I'm not likely to use an orange one. And last but not least, we have amber apathy. Now this is the yellow, and it comes out a bit, not coppery, more bronzish, I would say. Seeing it from here, it reminds me of oxidized brass or bronze. Oh, it's like a dark, dark gold. A deep, deep, dark gold. If gold were to oxidize, it would look like this. There's a good eye. It's almost green leaning, but I actually think that is the strong holographic interfering and creating a green tone. Okay, last swatch stick. I can hear something pulsing in the background. I'm sorry about that. I'm not sure what that is. We do have a train that runs in the distance. It could be that. But let's see. Oh, that's actually really pretty. Much like orange, I'm not a huge fan of yellow, but I do love a good mustard yellow. And what I'm seeing here, my love of food coming through, I see a spicy brown mustard. That one is pretty opaque for being so light. Almost like a roasted corn. The corn kid, he would approve. You should look up the corn kid if you don't know what I'm talking about. But I do love how it is like this rustic gold color. Like old hay. I'm definitely reminded of hay rides. Oh, that is so nice. What a beautiful collection of colors. Okay. Now I am going to bring all the colors back for a second swatch for each color so that I can get a good look, and you can also get a good look of all the colors in the Holo Taco Dark Rainbow collection. Alright, we're gonna do this again in the same order as before. So we have Into the Woods, a main contender. This was my original favorite, but Sunken Ship and Crimson Void are giving strong competition. That's really nice. Again, it's just such a nice deep forest green. I would say it leans. I'm trying to see if it's more neutral or cool or warm. But with the holographic shift, it's kind of all of those things, just depending on the lighting that you're in. I'm almost getting like Evil Queen as well. Evil Witch, perhaps. Something about that dark, poisony green. So once I do all of the second swatches, I will do a glossy taco, top coat. That's what will help me to choose. Each color is so beautiful, and I only do my nails so much. So I try to make wise choices from all of these beautiful options. This second coat of Sunken Secrets. I've been calling it Sunken Ships almost this whole time. Oops. Sunken Secrets. The second coat has really deepened it up. It's, again, most of these colors are darker than what is coming out on the camera. I really like that. Oh, I can't choose. I hope that the glossy top coat helps me decide. With many collections, there are 5. And with those, I will do 1 for each finger. But there's 7. In this one, so I feel like I need to make a choice and just do 1. Because then 3 would get repeated. That just wouldn't be fair. It wouldn't be symmetrical. And I like it to be symmetrical when possible. The second coat on a lot of these is making a huge difference. So maybe even if you think you don't need 2 coats, I would go ahead and try it. Especially if you have longer nails. Okay, that was again the Violet Nightmares. this is Dead Petals. I can tell that this one really needs another coat. I have said wow several times in this video, but it's true. They are all wowing me. This reminds me of the Scarlet Witch from the MCU, the Dead Petals. Just very much giving me Scarlet Witch energy. I think the crimson void would probably be closer to her actual color, but something about this tone just makes me think of her instead. It's so pretty. I love how distinct all seven of these polishes are. And even though they're dark, they're so bright, it's obvious what each color is. None of them look so dark that it's confusing what color they are supposed to be. Crimson Void. It's a very vampy shade. This is the third contender so far. It's between Into the Woods, Sunken Secrets, and Crimson Void. Crimson Void may be a good color to aim for on Halloween, but I do love how this looks against my skin. Oh, there's a good angle to show the color. It's a very Halloween-y color to me. Part of me wants to save this one for Halloween, but I'm not sure. Well, even if I don't do it this time, I will probably do this one at the end of October. Okay, now for Burnt Bridges. This one will also very much benefit from the second coat. It's so chocolatey, but at the same time, there's a redness to this brown that does kind of evoke that orange base, where this would normally be the orange of the rainbow. This, I think, would be a good one for Thanksgiving. Last, we have the amber apathy. At first glance, it does look brown, but it really is more gold toned with a bit of a green glow to it. It's a bit of a unique color. I could see this being a divisive color, as it is a bit of that yellow-green. But, as I mentioned before, it looks mustard, like a dark mustard. This may be one that would be good with a third layer, as it is the lightest of the bunch, but I will be leaving it at 2 for the swatch. While those second layers dry, the second coats, I am going to return the polishes to the box. Okay. I hope you enjoyed going over all of those polishes. I know I did. So now, I have a glossy taco I use for my swatches. I use the super glossy taco on my nails. This is just glossy taco. I'm not actually 100% sure what the difference is in the super glossy versus the glossy. It's something about the different chemicals used to make it. I bought it because I liked having all of the original products. I'm a collector. But now I use it for my swatches. Just a thick. And this one is a bit gloopy. I have had this glossy taco for, I guess, 3 years. So at this point, it is drying out a little, but look at that. Amazing. I am always, always shocked at how beautiful putting a top coat on makes these polishes. They're beautiful, and then you put this on and it's like, wow, I didn't even realize what I was missing. I was hoping this would help me decide, but it's making it a little harder to decide. This bottle is again old and almost empty, so having a bit of a time getting enough on here. When these top coats are new and not expired, they act perfectly, and I love them. This one is glooping up a bit due to old age. That's why I like using it for swatches. That way it doesn't go to waste, but I don't have to use it on my fingers. see all these strings. It's kind of like working with a hot glue gun when it gets old like this. And once these dry, I will show them all at once, and I can see a side-by-side comparison and hopefully make a choice. One of my flaws, I would say, is that I am a bit indecisive. I really love this one. And the Crimson Void. This one is the dead petals, and here's the Crimson Void. I'm starting to favor the dead petals now that I've got the glossy taco on it, but I still think I like this one better. But I was thinking I was gonna save this crimson one for Halloween time. So I could consider dead petals for this go-round instead. Trying to get most of the areas covered. Wow, the rainbow really shines through there on top of this burnt bridges. I also appreciate the amount of alliteration in this collection. Burnt bridges, amber apathy, sunken secrets. So clever. Almost made it even more gold. Yeah, I like that. Amber is a good color title. Okay. So I know that these swatches are not perfect, especially using this older top coat, but it's certainly going to do the trick for helping me decide which ones to use on my nails. So let's lay them out like that. Okay, we've got Into the Woods, Sunken Secrets, Violet Nightmares, Dead Petals, Crimson Void, Burnt Bridges, and Amber Apathy. I think the green is still my favorite. The blue is very close. So This is my favorite, and then the blue, and then the crimson. Well, I know I'm not going to do, not today, not the violet, not the burnt bridges, and not the amber apathy. These two side by side. They're much more different in person. I promise that. On camera, it's really not doing justice how different they actually are. Just trust me, these look much more different in person than on camera. But I think it's between the blue or the green. Where I am, it's still a bit warm outside, and it is still technically summer until the end of September. It's starting to feel cool on some days, but on other days it's still quite sunny. Lots of green. You know, I think sometimes my first choice, you gotta go with that. I think that green's the one. I love the way that that looks. So yes, I'm going to go with a green nail polish this time around on each nail. And you will be seeing that in future videos until I do the next manicure. So maybe you can keep an eye out for that. Those of you that watched this video. Thank you so much, everybody. I hope that you enjoyed this nail polish unboxing and object examination video. A bit of painting and swatching, all that color shifting goodness. Please let me know in the comments below which polish was your favorite. And please let me know if there's anything at all that you would like to see in the future. Please be sure to leave me a like if you liked the video. And if you aren't subscribed, please consider subscribing. Thank you again so much, everyone. I hope that you have a wonderful day and a wonderful night. Goodbye.